Thank you. Thank you very much. And good evening, everyone. I'm absolutely delighted to be here in Tel Aviv. My first time I've actually given a concert in Tel Aviv in my life, and I'm very excited about it. I'm very excited because I've got with me a group of wonderful people, a great band, a fantastic orchestra. A fantastic orchestra, as you know. And you are going to be meeting some of your most distinguished artists who are going to sing a lot of great songs for you. This evening is mainly songs written by John and Paul, the Beatles, and George, one song by George. And, of course, they are, I think, probably the greatest songwriters of this ending century. And I've been very privileged to work with them. And what you'll be hearing tonight will be my original scores and also some special score that I've done for this concert. So it isn't often you hear these works played by such good musicians as we have tonight. And I hope you enjoy it.
Oh, mountain where rocking horse people eat marshmallow pies. Everyone smiles as you drift past the flower that grows so incredibly high. Newspaper taxis appear on the shore, waiting to take you away. Climb in the back with your head in the clouds and you're gone. Lucy in the sky with time. Lucy in the sky with time. Lucy in the sky with time. We'll be right back.
Danny Robos, Joe Lerner, David Dorr. Thank you. Right now, we're going to do two songs together, and they're two young ladies. One's called Michelle, and the other's called Eleanor. Eleanor Rigby. And to sing them, we have the marvelous Shlomo Artzi.
Up the rice in the church where wedding has been. Lives in a dream, waits at the window, wearing a face that she keeps in a jar by the door. Who is it for? All the lonely people, where do they all come from? All the lonely people, where do Father Mackenzie, writing the words of a sermon that no one will hear. No one comes near, look at him working, darning his socks in the night when there's nobody there. What does he care? All the lonely people, where do they all come from? All the lonely people, where do they all? Church and was buried alone with her name. Nobody came, Father Mackenzie, wiping the dirt from his hands as he walks from the grave. No one was saved, all the lonely people. Where do they all come from? All the lonely, lonely people. Where do you. I'll get to you somehow. Until I do, I'm telling you, so you'll understand. Michelle, my babe, I will say the only words I know that you'll understand, my share.
Paul, of course, is the guy who always wrote the melodic bits. And I guess if you analyze all the songs that Lennon McCartney ever wrote, you'd find that about 60% of the ones that you hear most in tune form are Paul's. And I think John was always a little bit envious of that, because John, of course, was an equal and opposite genius and a marvelous writer. But he had a sneaky, you know, he used to sneer a little bit at Paul's, what he used to call his saccharine stuff or his sugar stuff. But I think he secretly envied it. And he once said to me, you know, George, I don't expect to walk into a bar in Spain and hear someone whistling I'm the Walrus. Well, you can understand what he's getting on about. And I'm the Walrus, of course, I think is one of his most anarchic songs. And when he actually first sang it to me with his guitar, I said, well, what do you want me to do with this, John? And he said, well, I want you to do a score. I said, any ideas? He said, that's your job. He said, I'd like a few strings and a bit of brass. Apart from that, you go and work it out. So I went and worked it out, and at least I tried to, because it was such a strange one. So I put in a lot of strange things. And I booked a choir. He didn't know about this. I booked a 12-piece choir, very legitimate people. But I wrote in the parts things like ha, 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 he, he, he's, and all those kind of things. And when John heard it, he fell around laughing. He thought it was great. And of course, the recording worked out of the way you noted. And here tonight to sing it is Hemi Rodden.
Thank you.
People often say that Paul was the softie and that John was the rock and roll tearaway. And that's true, but the reverse is also true, because after all, who sang Good Golly Miss Molly? Paul. Who wrote and sang Helter Skelter? Paul. Who wrote Across the Universe? John. Very soft. Who wrote Julia? Beautiful song. So they were both kind of, both sides of the same coin. And John one day was at home in New York, was it, or when it was London, I think, and he heard Yoko trying to make something out of Beethoven's Moonlight Sonata, not very well, playing the arpeggios that you all can play anyway. And he thought, those arpeggios sound rather good. And he kind of took them and modified them to his own use and came up with a song which he called Because. And we recorded it with John on guitar, me on electric harpsichord, and Paul on bass. And that was it. No other accompaniment except for some synthesizers we put on later. And then we added three tracks of voices with the three of them, John, Paul, and George, singing all the voices. So we ended up with nine voices with three tracks. And it's an extraordinary song for John. And I thought it would be a good idea to take it back to its classical roots. And I wrote a special arrangement for a violin solo, with still based on the original song. And tonight, the leader of our orchestra, Menachem Breuer, is going to play it for you. And David Dorr is also going to sing. Another Paul song, and back we have Yale Deckelbaum. Yale? You might hear the choir doing some funny things at the beginning of this. It's all meant.
Desmond has a barrow in the marketplace. Molly is a singer in a band. Desmond says to Molly, girl, I like your face. And Molly says this as she takes him by the hand. Oh, bloody, oh, bloody, la, la, goes on. Ra, la, la, the life goes on. Jewelry store, buys a 20 carat golden ring, takes it back to Molly waiting at the door, and as he gives it to her, she begins to sing. Oh, bloody, bloody.
Now, some years ago, I was in Montserrat, not long after John died, and I had an idea for a piece of music that was a little bit sad. And I wrote it as a score, put it on one side, because there was no reason to use it for anything, unless I was writing a film or something. People didn't like, you know, there's no use for a tune as such. And I put it on one side and forgot about it until last year. I made a record, my last record, with a lot of great people, and I called the record In My Life, because the words of John's song mean so much to me, because I've been so lucky in my life to have worked with some great people, and some of them are dead, some are living, and I love them all, and that's really what John says in his lyrics. And so I dug out my old tune, which I'd scored, and I decided to use this as an introduction. I called it Friends and Lovers, and I use it as an introduction to his song. And after all, his song in my life, it's got a bit of me in it anyway, because the middle bit, the instrumental, I wrote one evening when they were out to supper and played it for John when he got back, and he was delighted with it, so it stayed in. A little harpsichord piece. It is on strings tonight. And to perform it tonight for you is Shlomo Artzi.
יש מקומות שאזכור אותם כל חיי, למרות שכמה מהם השתנו בוודאי, כמה מהם השתנו לעולמים ולא לטובה, כמה מהם נעלמו עם השנים ורק כמה נשארו בסביבה. בכל המקומות האלה היו רגעים גדולים עם אוהבים וחברים שאני יכול לזכור. כמה מהם מתו מזמן וכמה נשארו בחיים לאורך כל חיי. I love them.
I love you more.
George Harrison was quite a good composer in his own right, and I tended to ignore him in the first days because I was spoiled with the others. You know, the others were so good, I didn't really need a third guy. But he came through and he started writing some brilliant songs. And one of the first ones that I thought was really, really great was a song that we're now going to perform as a special piece, a special guitar solo, which I wrote for John Williams, the classical guitar player. And tonight we have it performed by Avi Singoda. And I think you'll find he plays it every bit as good as John Williams. I haven't introduced you to my band, or rather not my band, your band. And they've been a tremendous support to me, and I can't thank them enough for what they've done. First of all, Gil Feldman on keyboards. of course, Avi Singolda. On rhythm guitar, Ami Ophir. On bass guitar, Yossi Menachem. And on drums, the one and only, Mea Yisrael. And there's a beautiful crowd of people at the back here have been singing their hearts out. And I'd like you to give a warm welcome, not a welcome, but a thank you, to the choir of the Rimon School.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, Sir George Martin.
I've written a few film scores in my time, not very many because I'm basically a backroom boy, but I did work on a film, a Bond film, James Bond film, the first one that Roger Moore appeared in, and it was called Live and Let Die. And a friend of mine wrote a good song for it. And I orchestrated it, and I did the rest of the film score. And at the end of the day, they gave me a Grammy Award for it, which I was rather pleased about that. So now we're going to hear it. And to sing it, we have, I'm on myself, because I've got so many of these names that I have to remember. And I know the names, but I'm just trying to think of the order in which they come. And for Live and Let Die, we've got Yul Lerner, and you all know Yul Lerner. And beautiful Yale Deckelbaum. Yale?
When you were young and your heart was an open book, you used to say, if this ever-changing world in which we're living makes you give in and cry, say, live and let die. just the same, live and let live. But if this ever-changing world in which you're living makes you give in and cry,
so live and let die.
The score that I did was for a cartoon film, and it was an animated film about the Beatles. And when the Beatles heard about it, they were quite horrified. They hated the idea. They learned that the people who were going to make it were the people who made Popeye. And they didn't like the idea one bit. But fortunately, the film was being directed by a very good man called George Dunning, a Canadian, who had very good taste indeed. And he created, I think, well, what has become now a fairly legendary picture, Yellow Submarine. And not many people realize that it does take a long time to make an animated film. The Disney people never take less than 2 years, and generally it's more like 3 years to create a full-length animation. George Dunning was given exactly 1 year from start to finish to make this film, and he did it with a team of English animators, and I was asked to do the musical score, and time was so short that he and I worked very closely together, and he said, look, you just have to write what you think is appropriate because I'm too busy finishing the film to think about it much. I'll give you everything that comes off the production line as it does. So he would give me reel 4 and then reel 7 and reel 9 and so on. Gradually the film would be assembled and I would look at each bit. Sometimes there were bits missing, storyboards. I had a moviola in my house. I made my own measurements. And I just went ahead and said, well, okay, we'll do it that way. If you like, we might have a fight, and I might end up on the cutting room floor. But in fact, very little did. And nearly an hour of music was written and recorded, and most of it went into the film. So I put together some of the themes from that film. It starts off, as you know, with Pepperland, that lovely, beautiful place, which is immediately ruined by the Blue Meanies. And I guess you'll hear something of that in the Yellow Submarine suite that we're going to play now. Thank you. course, we've been dealing all the time tonight with John and Paul, but George Harrison was quite a good composer in his own right. And I tended to ignore him in the first days because I was spoiled with the others. You know, the others were so good, I didn't really need a third guy. But he came through and he started writing some brilliant songs. And one of the first ones that I thought was really, really great was a song that we're now going to perform as a special piece, a special guitar solo, which I wrote for John Williams, the classical guitar player. And tonight we have it performed by Avi Singoda. And I think you'll find he plays it every bit as good as John Williams.
Thank you.
Now please welcome Danny Rabas.
Has left
Remember Abbey Road? I mean, the record, not the studios. And it finishes up with a piece that you don't hear very much. One of my favorite pieces. And it is called Golden Slumbers. And here is Joel to sing it for us. Thank you, Joel. And of course, we'll have some fireworks from Avi and from Mayer, I hope, and from the orchestra.
Once I was away to get back home, once I was away to get back home, sleep pretty darling, do not cry, and I will sing a lullaby. Get back home. Once I was away to get back home. Sleep pretty darling, do not cry, and I will sing a lullaby. Thank you.
Well done. The organ. The choir. Bravo, everybody. Thank you so much. God. You don't want more, do you? Okay, let's do some more.
God bless you all. Peace be with you.